Good afternoon and welcome to Fortress Press Live, where we connect you with the people and passions behind the books we publish here at Fortress Press. Today we'll pick up with part two of our interview with Michael Gibson, and we'll continue our discussion about the work he does behind the scenes as an acquisitions editor for theology resources at Fortress Press. When you'd mentioned manuscripts a little bit ago, and so I think it'd be kind of interesting, you know, a lot of our audience I think is going to be made up of folks who are interested in the kinds of work we publish or might be interested in publishing their own works with us. So from your perspective as an acquisitions editor, talk to us about, you know, what are some of the elements that really make a potential project stand out to you?
Right. I think one of the biggest elements for me is really a sense of how this particular project, how does this project get me to think about a particular issue or a particular topic or a particular figure? And further, how does that project sort of link that way of thinking to a larger ecosystem within that field of knowledge? So I really find myself gravitating towards projects that take on the challenge of revising how we understand either at a single issue level or even at a micro level, how we understand or interpret those particular issues or thinkers, or at a much larger level, revising, you know, kind of standard, long-standing patterns of interpretation. For me, the topics are, I don't want to say secondary, but I look for certain genetic elements or patterns, such as how does a project get me to think about certain figures, or how does a project revise my understanding of how to interpret certain things. Those kind of things really stand out to me. Other kinds of projects, you know, they might be more orientational. That is, they, you know, at a certain level, they introduce a particular area or a particular part of a subject. But they, you know, they do it in a way that it kind of challenges ways of approaching or ways of thinking about those things. And that seems to be, I think, a hallmark of a lot of theological conversation right now, is kind of this movement towards kind of disrupting the way we think about particular topics, or the way that we approach certain figures or relationships within that body of knowledge.
Well, that's helpful. Thanks for giving us some of those insights. And I think it's a good transition point into our next question, which is to talk about some of the projects that you've worked on. Maybe share with us about two of the completed projects that are particularly interesting or were fascinating to you. And then maybe give us a little bit of insight into one of the projects you're currently working on.
Sure. Well, I think sort of related to the type of kind of that pattern of thinking or elements that I'm very interested in, several of our recent projects embody that. And one, for instance, that was just released is Steve Long's Saving Karl Barth, which revises a very long-standing pattern of interpreting Barth's relationship to von Balthasar in particular, in Catholic theology in general. Two projects that have recently completed the editorial process that I would draw attention to and kind of do similar things would be Oliver Crisp's forthcoming book, Deviant Calvinism, which will be out this fall. And he takes kind of a similar approach to contemporary evangelical versions of Calvinism and kind of raising questions about the genealogy of those interpretations of Calvinism and taking a kind of a constructive revisionist approach to the contours of Calvinism and the legacy of Calvinism and how that gets redeployed and the way that particular issues are understood within that. Kind of the upshot of that book is sort of a inherent diversity within Calvinism rather than kind of a very narrow, singular type of Calvinism. Calvinism is actually a rather broad tradition that within that there are a diversity of ways that one can construct certain theological issues. And I think that's going to be a really exciting and really provocative book. Another, and this will probably be out early next year, is a book by David Congdon on Rudolf Bultmann. And again, he takes that kind of revisionist approach and really provides a thorough reinterpretation of Bultmann's work, specifically Bultmann's program of demythologizing. And he sets this out in relationship to dialectical theology, and in particular the thought of Karl Barth. And there's a kind of a standard paradigm of interpreting that relationship in which there was an overriding assumption that Barth and Bultmann were kind of antagonistically related in their respective theological projects. And what David does is to really take that whole way of understanding that relationship and thoroughly recontextualizes it, reinterprets it, and puts Bultmann into a kind of a whole new relationship with Barth and with dialectical theology. And it completely revises that whole trajectory within 20th century theology. And I think that really what it does is pretty groundbreaking in terms of really the constructive upshot of how those two thinkers related, of how those two thinkers pursued dogmatic theology and their subsequent influence on really the rest of the 20th century. It's a very large project, but I think that that's one that will have a tremendous impact on how we read and interpret much of modern theology.
Well, thank you for taking a few minutes to give us some kind of previews of some books folks should be on the lookout for. And for the listeners who are interested in finding out more about those titles, I'll be sure to include links in the show notes for this episode. And Mike, we just appreciate you so much for being generous with your time today and for giving us kind of a window into the life of an acquisitions editor. So thanks so much for sharing with us.
Thanks very much. I appreciate you setting all of this up and inviting me on.
Thanks for being a part of my conversation today with Mike Gibson. This is part two of a two-part interview series. To view the show notes for this episode or to leave a comment, head over to fplive.fortresspress.com/005. Fortress Press Live is available via iTunes, SoundCloud, Stitcher, and even YouTube, so be sure to subscribe on your favorite podcast distribution network. Until next time, this is your host, Sean Tabbitt, signing off.